So today's topic is gemstones and remedies. Now, I have talked about gemstones in my previous videos as well, in which I have talked about energized gemstones and the non-energized gemstones. But today, the topic is a bit different because somebody was asking me from a very long time on Gmail. In fact, not somebody, many people are asking me. These kind of questions come to us often, that, you know, gemstones, do they work? And if they work, in what sense they work, and which planets gemstones we should be wearing. So we are too confused about this fact that, you know, whether gemstones work, and if they work, what kind of gemstones we should be wearing, and for which planets we should be wearing, and the remedies do take place, or this is just, you know, a gimmick that gemstones work. So see, I would start by saying that first of all, definitely gemstones work, but what kind of gemstones work is an important question, and for what purpose gemstones should be used is another purpose. Okay, so see, you need to understand, first of all, I always say that even if you buy the most expensive real gemstone, when I talk about real gemstone means that, for example, real diamond, if somebody has recommended you wear diamond for your planet Venus, and if you buy real diamond also of a very good quality, but if it is not energized, okay, on your particular name, and energization, I always say, it is not that you just wash the gemstone with milk, do 108 mantras of that particular planet, which are these, you know, easily available on YouTube or on Google, and it will be energized. No, that's not the way it is, like normal pundits do. It's not like that at all. This is the reason gemstones don't work. You have to get them energized. I have made a separate video on this about energized gemstones. You can actually see on Mahakali Vedic Healing Shelter channel. So right now, I'm not going into the details of energizations and how energizations happen. There's a video for this. Right now, I'm talking about that it should be energized, the gemstone. And very importantly, you have to understand that you will only wear gemstones for those planets which are beneficial for you. Okay, the biggest fault that people do is that planets in your horoscope which are not good for you also, sometimes astrologers, few astrologers I would say, recommend that, you know, this planet is not at a good placement or is weak, so you wear this gemstone for this particular planet. That's wrong. You should only give strength, and you should only strengthen that energy of that planet which is beneficial for you. Because see, if some planet is working in a negative way for you, and the placement is bad for it, and you already start wearing a gemstone of that particular planet, you're giving more strength to the negativity. Okay, you're giving more strength to the fact that things that were working against you will start working more against you, because you have given strength to something which is evil, something which is negative. Okay, this is something which is common sense, but, you know, people, they don't realize this because they don't know the knowledge behind this. So they start wearing gemstones for weak planets. Yes, you should wear gemstones for weak planets, energized gemstone, but only those planets which are working in favor for you. Okay, like, and you should always remember. Now, another question that comes to me is that if my planet Venus is very weak, and if it is in a good placement, okay, and sometimes you will see in your horoscope that, you know, there is a number which is written on one particular house of the horoscope, in your horoscope, Kundli, which you call, okay, but it's not existing. It's not, it's just a number which is a reference, which is called a planet. This is a little technical that I'm talking. To simplify, I would like to say the planet which is, which can be there, the possibility of that planet to be there or to activate that planet which is working in your favor, which is not written in, you know, capital letters. If, for example, Mars planet is right sitting right there in that particular house, okay, if it's written out there, it's definitely, then if it's working for you, you wear a planet gemstone of Mars, it will work for you. But if there is a planet which there is a number which is written, for example, Moon is written, that is number 5 out there, and that can be activated, which can work for you, you should wear gemstone for that activation of that planet which is right now dead. You can wear gemstone for that also. Now, how remedies happen is that, for example, if you are looking for you know, emotional stability or emotional or mental stability, then of course moon planet is there. The placement needs to be seen for that, because moon is related to your mind and your emotions and everything. Okay, so but you have to also see in the horoscope that whether the placement of your moon is in favor or not, because if you will wear a moon gemstone, if it is not in your favor, the planet, you will start having more depression, you will start having more mental issues and so many other things. Okay, so remedies of gemstones, remedies through gemstones do happen, but provided it is working in your favor, that is my point. Okay, from all the aspects I have tried to explain this to you. Okay, and those energized gemstones you should be wearing, that strengthens that planet and gives you benefits from that planet. Okay, and always remember, whenever you will give strength to the correct planet, the characteristics which are positive in that planet will arise automatically with time. It doesn't happen in 1 or 2 days. It takes months, maybe 4 or 5 months for that activation to happen, but you will start seeing changes in yourself. Okay, so it can be any planet for that matter. Okay, so it's not necessary that you're supposed to buy very expensive gemstones. You can buy substitutes also, gemstones which have good color, and then get them energized. So if you people are looking for any remedy of regarding the gemstones, or if your planets are weak which are in your favor, get the diagnosis done. We'll get to know that which planets are there which are in your favor and which need strength and energization, and that particular characteristics of the planet will be activated in a positive way for you, and you will actually feel the difference in your life. Slowly but definitely you will feel your personality starts changing. There's so many positive things that starts happening, but don't over expect things, because you know right now you'll say, Didi, you said everything will be fine, everything. It takes time, and it depends from person to person also, the karmic accounts of a person also. Don't think of that person, oh yes, he was wearing a Venus and he became, you know, so rich and he became so romantic, or relationships started happening. It really depends on your Venus placement and also your past karmic accounts also. Okay, so never compare things. Your kundli, your horoscope, your destiny is yours, and someone one's destiny belongs to the other person. You see your benefit, the maximum that can happen to you as a benefit is something that you should be focusing on. Okay, so that's about it. Next week I'll come up with another topic. Till then, goodbye.